A progressive web app, or PWA, is a popular way in which you can develop a mobile app that functions on just a web browser and comes with some added features to ease the development process. Hi, I'm Ryan from Webiotic. In this video, we'll take you through the world of progressive app development, how it can benefit your project, and how to build your own. A progressive web app essentially combines technology from mobile apps and web apps to offer a mobile experience that's both user-friendly and easier to develop. A PWA looks and feels just like a normal mobile app, but with the ease that comes with creating a website. Here are some benefits of PWA apps. Available offline. While websites and apps aren't typically available offline, PWAs are mobile-like behavior. Progressive web apps get the best of both worlds. They receive the benefits of website functionality, like database access and dynamic data, but they also look and feel just like a native mobile app. Easy installation. A PWA can be installed right onto a device from either a website or app store. Just keep in mind that not all app stores allow for progressive app distribution. Currently, you can download PWAs from Google Play, but not Apple's App Store, for example. Access to hardware. Just like with regular mobile apps, PWAs can also access device hardware features, such as camera and GPS. Now, let's take a look at the steps you'll need to take to create your own PWA. Use SSL. Remember, you're creating a mobile app that runs on a web browser, so serving it over HTTPS is crucial. SSL adds an additional layer of web security and will help your users feel secure when using your mobile app. HTTPS is also needed for progressive web applications in order to use service workers, which we'll get into later. Create an application shell. Your application shell is the first thing your users will see after downloading your app. It ensures that your application will load reliably and instantly on user screens, similar to native apps. This shell is made up of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and powers the UI. It also caches so that the shell doesn't need to be loaded each time a user visits the app. Register a service worker. A service worker is a type of web worker. It's basically a JS file that runs separately from the primary browser thread. In short, it gives you access to many PWA features like caching, push notifications, install prompts, and more. Add a web app manifest. The only way users can install your app is by including a manifest.json file in the root dictionary. This is a simple file that tells the browser how the PWA should behave once installed on a user's device. It gives your web app a more native-like feel on users' home screens. Set up the install prompt. If your PWA has a service worker and a web app manifest, the user's browser will prompt them to install the app to their home screen. You'll need to configure an install prompt for this to occur. You can also configure the prompt for various situations, such as when a user takes a specific action. LIGHTHOUSE for app audit. LIGHTHOUSE is a great PWA analysis tool by Google. It can be used to audit a progressive web app's features. It tests for app speed, offline ability, security, and accessibility best practices. This tool is available as a Chrome extension and a command line tool. Progressive web apps are the future of the mobile web, and more companies and industries are using this new standard to improve their performance. PWAs are fast, reliable, and engaging, all while maintaining native app experience. I hope you learned something today about how to build a PWA. For more help with your app, subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, please like it and share it with others. Thank you for watching.